Tool's the Patient, by the way, in case you're wondering. That's my little screw you, YouTube. Everybody's favorite good guy. TYE. Superman. Oh, I got it right first try. Yes. Winning. Oh, too many gimmicks, man. It's been so long. Pinkies up. Winkies. Clinkies. Gentle. Offend anybody. No. How y'all doing? It's been over 2 months. Oops. First, I wanted to address some heat. Oof. Oh, the heat. Some comments behind the scenes, some messages. People sliding into my DMs. If I had DMs, I don't. But sliding into my DMs saying, "Where are you? We miss you. We haven't seen you in a couple months now. Where's your video? Where you been?" And these are the same people I'm thinking of too, right now, off the top of my head. Sorry. That also say, "Why do you do these videos? You're all about yourself. You're selfish." And I'm sorry to go dark on you, but I think it's funny. Not ha-ha funny, but funny, strange funny. I just want to address this first. Listen, life happens. I do have a life outside of this. Ironically, maybe not so ironic, but relatively, I'm the same person here on this than I am out there. And I know you two, personally. Yeah. Well, next time I see you, I'm not going to be so nice. But you're a nice guy. You're supposed to be a nice guy. So are you two. Gee, you really make me want to do these every week. Takes a couple people to ruin it for everybody else, doesn't it? I won't mention you by name. I've got a little bit more class than that. Sorry, everybody. Hi. How you doing? It's been a minute. I miss you all. I do. I miss talking to every single one of you. And that's the cool part. Just to kind of switch the mood here. I'm sorry, that was bad. But hey, I'm honest. I'm your average honest Joe. That's what I do. Like I said, this is me, and it's also me out there. And these are the same two individuals saying that I put on a show for the camera. That I'm that pretentious, right? And that I'm fake. Well, you just got blocked. We're gonna have ourselves a conversation next time I see you. Ooh, putting out fires all over the place, that's what I do. I work too damn hard for negativity like that. Way too damn hard. I try to be positive. I try to be reaffirming as an individual. I try to show respect. I try to be honorable. Does this sound familiar to all the rest of you? I'm sorry, I'm probably boring and I'm being repetitious, but hey, I've always said it. I am what I am. I say what I am. I'm not making this about me. just so you know, this isn't just about me. I do these videos, these vlogs, these coffee times for a community's sake. A community of people that I do know personally, for the most part. Some I've met on here, on YouTube, here specifically. I do it for them too, because they're nice people. They are loving people. They show me respect, I show them respect in return. That's how friendships work. And I love that. I love that. I love seeing people be there for each other. That's a weakness. Call it my kryptonite, okay? Superman and all that bullshit. That's my weakness, because that's what this world needs now. As cliche as that sounds, all we need is love. Yeah, okay, well, we do, okay. The universe, and I've said it before, I'll say it again. Again, I'm sorry to be repetitious one more time, but the universe is pointed towards the nasties. It's quite obvious. I'm sure all of you are experiencing that in your environments. And I'm sorry. Where's the light going? It's supposed to be sunshiny. What the hell? Oh, well. I can't control the sunlight. Sorry. I got another comment about that, too. Anyway, not the point. French vanilla. Yeah. Bring on. It's a little dark, though. I don't know if I can show you. In the dark. It's dark in here, so you probably can't see it. I should probably put more cream in that, but rev it up. I look like three shades of hell today, and I'm kind of thankful it's getting dark because this don't look so good. Because if I was doing this for myself, don't you think I'd be all dolled up and blah, blah, blah? Ty, get off it. Anyway, I love seeing people, back to my point, I love seeing people being there for each other, taking care of one another. That's a weakness of mine. It's the way I was raised. It's the way that I've always known to be. I'm shown by great, great people in my life, and there's probably a handful of them that always taught me to show love first and be there for somebody else. My dad being one of them. Get one. Rub the wall one time. Miss you, love you. Every day. Strong figures in my life, same idea. I'm very, very fortunate to have them, and they've always taught me to be there for others first before yourself, to be selfless. And to see that, to see you all taking care of each other, and to see like some of the comments back and forth, I've even seen a few conversations. Nobody in particular that I'm doing this with on camera, but you know, say on my Facebook or some social media somewhere. I only have Facebook. I don't have X or whatever the hell it's called. I don't have that or, excuse me. But I see on Facebook and I see people giving each other love and respect. And, you know, I love you, man. I love you, too. And it's cool to see. Where is the light going? Anyways. And that's part of the theory why I do this with all of you here. At the same time, because, you know, here, give me a second, I'm gonna see, sorry for being rude, getting to my point in a minute here, just give me one second, hopefully that's a little better, maybe, just, there's no light, so, anyway, and I love seeing that, and we definitely need more of that. We need more of just being honest with each other and showing love to each other in an honest fashion is what I'm saying. Dark times are still ahead of us and we're all we got, you know, so don't abuse that, you know. It's what I believe in, you know, it's what you should believe in. The truth is a very funny thing. I will defend it to the end of my life. Not my version of the truth. The truth. The truth. Let's be clear. Okay? Clarity is another good word to use. Just be honest. Just be a positive but loving person, like, in an honest fashion. Like, you're built to do that. You know? Doesn't take much effort to just be there for somebody. You know, if it does take a lot of effort, maybe you should rethink some thoughts for yourself that it's such a burden to you that you're helping somebody else. Like, if you find something about that, that's wrong somehow, the problem's you. What do I know, right? 20 years ago, I was a different cat. I was a fathead. I had an ego, and I thought it was all about me. Say what you want to about me. I already know. You have to improve the quality of life. And one of the ways to do that, I have so much to say this. I won't, but I have so much to say. One of the ways to do that is to be there for other people before yourself. It's gratifying, you know? I'm so grateful. I am very, very grateful that people take a chance on me when they don't have to. You know, and so many chances on me. And they don't have to. They all know who I mean, you know, when I'm saying that. I'm so grateful. I'm very gracious. That's respect. That's honor. That's integrity. Somehow they see that I have those same things, those same qualities. I don't know how they see that. I don't want to know the formula to where that's the way they are towards me. I don't want to figure that out. And I always want to know everything. I have a thirst for knowledge, like you would believe, obviously. Rabbit holing about all kinds of different stuff. Like, again, I could be saying a lot more here, but I'm not gonna. I don't know how or why they treat me the very best the way they do, but I'm so thankful. And I always take a minute to say thank you for everything. And if I don't do it often enough, then shame on me. You know, everything in my life wasn't handed to me for free. I didn't get it for free. There isn't handouts. I've always had to work hard to get what I got. And it's gratifying in the long run. Again, I can say so much. And that's why I want to be there for others. That's why I want to be there for all of you, for example. Most of you I know personally. Some of you I've just known on here, on YouTube specifically, to be clear. And you're all loved by me. And I'm very thankful. Grateful towards you all. To even just take a second out of your life, take 20 minutes, and I'm sorry if you can't get those 20 minutes back. You can blame me for it. It's fine. Seriously, though, all jokes aside, I want to take the opportunity to thank you all for your friendship, for your respect, and for your love. However you show love, I want to thank you for that. I recognize it. I see it. And I give it back. You're all beautiful and wonderful, amazing individuals. Hardworking, you know. Some of you really work hard, and I acknowledge that. I really want to thank you for that, you know, because what you do is not easy. Not easy. But then again, if it were easy, we'd all be doing it. So, and then it would take the whole meaning out of the whole thing, wouldn't it? Right? So, what I do isn't easy. Not by any stretch of the term. There's nothing easy. I put it on myself, though. And I've said this, again, not to be repetitious, but I've said this before. Always put it on myself. You know, I always have. It's an old habit from when I was younger, when I was taught in a very harsh manner to just take care of things. Just that mindset, right? Like, goal-oriented, if that makes sense. Like, you're just focused on getting things done. I still have that same focus today. Thanks, Dad. I miss you. I love you. Get one. Rub the wall one time. Get one. But I was taught in a very harsh fashion just to stay on the straight and narrow. Like, just to get things done. And I've been stuck in that. It feels like I've been stuck in that box for most of my life. You know? As I got older, like now, for example, I'm turning 41 in November, right? So I'm not a spring chicken. But especially now these days, like when we all get older, right? Like we have that, you're like, damn, you know? And now you're kind of stuck in it. And like sometimes it feels that way. Not to be negative, but just realistically, you know, some of you know what I'm talking about. Especially after you have children and stuff. I'm not blessed that way yet, but not that I know of. Especially after you have children, as I've observed, you know, and talk to brand new parents that say they're 35 plus, you know, and it's their first child, and they tell me all kinds of things, and I'm like, I can't imagine. I mean, you know, and we're assholes before, you know what I mean? And then I can't imagine. I can't imagine. It's, you're all incredible. It's wonderful. I love having conversations in depth like that, just to kind of to feed off of what you're saying, just so I can get an idea of, you know, what you go through. And oh, you know, I shake my head, and thank God there's no BB in a tin can up here when I shake my head. I don't make excuses. I don't make excuses. I never did, you know. You're all nuts, you know, myself included, just as guilty. It takes one to know one, believe me. You have to be, right? Crazy in a good way, right? Because some of you that I'm mentioning that work that hard or that have that first child after they're 35 plus, you know, or 40 even, same age as me. Like, I can't imagine. Like, you gotta be tapped into something nuts, right? You gotta be tapped into something crazy in order to do what you do, you know? Let alone with what you did before. But before you had the kid or before you are in the situation when you're older now and you finally realize that, damn, now I'm in it. You know, like, now we're in it. There's gotta be a part of you even before that that says, you know, shit, you know, now I'm older now, there's no excuses, right? And that's what you do. And I love having those conversations. It's, you know, I learn a lot. Like, I'm always learning, that thirst for knowledge, you know? Always learning. And the things I find myself learning are good life lessons, you know? It's all based off experience, thankfully. Like, nobody's gonna judge me for wanting to know more, I guess, but you're all incredible. And again, I'm sorry it took me so long to post one of these up, but real life happens, you know. I'm still going through shit too, you know, and it's not like I haven't told y'all. Like, I can't sit down here all the time. I'm happy to be sitting now, because sitting is not one of my strong points, okay? I'm always just flying, like. But that's one of those things, isn't it? And I end up telling myself off, going, well, now you're in it. You did this to yourself, Ty. I have nobody else to blame but myself for that. And all I can do is laugh, right? You can see the genuine smile on my face right now. I'm sitting here shaking my head at myself, going, man, the hell did you do, right? Listen. I wish you all well out there. You know, I haven't stopped thinking about you. There was a point in time a couple weeks ago where I thought I could sit down and do one of these and be in the right mind space just to, you know, to not be so negative. Sorry it started off a little negative, but roller coaster, right? Try living my life for about a week. You'll understand. Trust me. Excuse me. You know, but there was a point where I could have, but it's just, you know, I just wasn't right in the right headspace. It's because of the individuals that give me heat for even doing these, which doesn't really make me feel like doing these. You know what I mean? I do take criticism well. It's just the fact that I know them personally, and I'm going, okay, where's your videos? Asshats. Right? It takes a couple people to ruin it for everybody else, doesn't it? I've gotten questions too, and before I go, I'll let you get back to your life. Because it's already been 20 minutes, I'm sorry. I'm full of hot air, I guess. Yeah. I'm full of a lot of things. You can call me anything you want to call me. you have the freedom to do so. Just make good decisions in your life while you're judging somebody. That's all I'm saying. I've also gotten a few messages and comments about when's the next time you're going live. Dude, like I said last time, I'm trying to work on it. I don't sit well. This is me sitting. And right now I'm thinking, oh, Jesus, I gotta, you know. Thank you. Thank you for that, you know. I appreciate that. It's nice to know once in a while, just to get feedback, you know, in a positive sense, in a loving sense. It's nice to know that people look forward to hanging out and stuff, because that's what the lives on this channel are all about. It's not about me, you know, it's about all of us, so we all hang out. I miss it too, I really do. You know, at first I was like, and Kev, you can attest to this. Hi, Kev, by the way, miss you, man. At first I was like, yeah, live just isn't my thing, you know. But then you get people like, you know, one of my bosses showing up, for example, a buddy of mine, who I respect beyond words, and I'm very thankful for him too. I can say so much there too, all in a positive sense, where really cool people show up, and then, you know, we have dialogue and we have conversation. That's what I do it for. I'm not doing it for me. I do it for all of us, you know. I mean, maybe a little bit me in there too, because I get to hang out with you. I'm not doing it just to put my face on camera, right? Does that make sense? I'm not in this for me, clearly. So, heat, stop it. Just stop. Go kick rocks, you know? Go play Frogger in traffic, all right? Go do something more productive for yourself. If you're gonna, you know, come at me for less than, I mean, that's weird to me. Okay, and I know them, so trust me, I'll be having conversations with them. And they aren't going to be good. Because I am not scared to go straight up to your face and ask you the question as to why would you say that. I'm not afraid of nothing. You know? Lightning? Yes. I have my reasons. Being on a boat and doing this shit? Yes. I have my reasons. Okay? Other than that, I have no fear. I don't live in fear. And I will defend those when it's right. It's got to be the right thing. The truth, right? I'm not afraid. You know? So. But thank you for that. So, when's the next time you go on live? I don't know. I really don't. I mean, it took long enough just to have coffee with you, right? It's been over 2 months. Again, I apologize, sincerely, and it's genuine. Life happens, man, you know? I'm going through shit, too, you know? Whether it be relationship-wise, personal relationship-wise, you know? A lot of things happen, a lot of things go on. How am I doing, ultimately? I'm all right. I'm okay. Exhausted. Sore. Very exhausted, actually. I have today off. Thank you. And I have Friday off. Don't get any ideas. Friday, I do not exist. So. And that's the thing, too. When I get days off, I'm invisible. If there's ever a right time to make me the invisible man, I don't exist. Leave me be. You know? I work too damn hard. I really do. You know, it takes a lot. I love you all. I want to thank you for hanging with me, you know, for showing me love and positivity and for being genuine with me. I really appreciate that. Again, it's a weakness. And I want to thank you for all being there for each other. I see it all the time, and it's wonderful. It warms my heart. It does, and we are all capable of giving love and being there for other people. Give it a shot, you know? Take somebody out for coffee, you know what I mean? Et cetera, et cetera. Go for a walk in the park, have a picnic, you know? Be there, for each other. As much as a Fred Rogers special I sound like, or a Dr. Phil episode, and in my opinion, not a real doctor, by the way. But, you know, just be there for each other. As it took me over 2 months to do one of these. I'm sorry, I know. It's the irony. You know, I feel like a hypocrite when I say that, but I'm not a hypocrite. I'm just a busy dude. Legit. Like, legit busy. I'm going to see on the other side how much longer it's going to take in between these, but... And I still have going live in the back of my head, okay? So, seriously, I thank you for asking me. I honestly don't know. All I can do is try. And try is what I do. So, thank you for watching and listening and providing feedback. You know, if not on a personal level, then on a public one. You can comment below. I say it all the time, but just do it. You know, let me know how you're doing. It's not about me. It's about us. We. There's no I in TYE. God bless you. I wish you all well. And hope I see you soon. Sooner than later. Because I really do enjoy this. You know, I do. Again, it's a hobby. It's something I chose to do to keep in touch with everybody at the same time. So this way I'm not wasting my wrist power typing out things to people that I don't normally talk to. I'm wishing you all well, and even though dark times are ahead, just take care of yourself. Take care of yourselves, okay? And each other, for sure. I'm thinking about a lot of you. I really am. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here having coffee. So, hopefully I'll see you sooner than later, okay? Thanks for giving me 30 minutes of your time. I love you. I miss you. And I'll always be here for you. That's a promise. And I keep my promises. Man of my word. I'm very proud of that. It's the truth. It's the right thing to do. It's not out of ego. It's not out of personal preference. Because I think I'm more important than somebody else, because I don't. It's teamwork, man. We're in it to win it. Winning! Pinkies up. Winkies. Clinkies. Gentle. Love tap. Cheers. Yeah, that coffee's a little darker than I wanted it to be, but hey. That's some good bean, baby. Send me a message. Let me know how you are. You know? Yeah. I'd really appreciate that. Thanks. Thank you very much. I'm very grateful. God be with you. And your families. And your friends and their families. The list goes on. Best of luck. All of my love. And I'll see you next time. Hopefully sooner than later. I hope. If you see me out there, tap me on the shoulder. Say hi. Give me a hug. And now that the sunlight's completely gone, that's my cue. Remember, if you're working too hard, keep doing it. I love you all. And I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.